In this video, we'll cover how to set up an AB test, some of the use cases and best practices. So let's go. So what is an AB test? An AB test is a way to run controlled experiments between two versions of something in your app to determine which is more effective. Your audience is segmented into two user groups, the control group and your test group. A variable is introduced to the test group and the performance is measured and compared with that of the control group. Our AB testing is powered by real-time analytics and best used for testing monetization strategies and new waterfall configurations. The big benefit of AB testing is that you're able to measure the impact of your changes made to the waterfall before you roll them out to 100% of your audience. So with this data-driven approach, you're able to optimize with confidence, knowing your changes have proven net positive results. So before we hop into the demo, let's talk real quick about what is the main goal of an AB test. That goal is to understand the value or the incremental revenue gain of adding a new network or adding new price floors to a mediated network, or testing refresh rates or frequency caps to find the right balance of revenue and impressions while maintaining user engagement. So these are the three main use cases. And the goal is always to see if there's any sort of meaningful revenue lift, or more specifically, a meaningful ARPDAU, average revenue per daily active user lift. So with that said, let's go to set up an AB test. So we'll hop into one of our ad units. So we're in one of our ad units, and we're going to set up an AB test. So the first step is to click these three little dots and hit create an AB test. So here you're presented with a screen that allows you to determine the test group allocation. And here we just default to 50%. You can pick different percentages if you want, but we recommend 50% so you have an equal number of users between the control group and the test group, and so you can accurately compare the two groups. You're also given an option to copy the existing ad unit configuration into the test ad unit, meaning like the ad unit configuration, all your network partners, just your waterfall setup, you can copy it into the test group. And this is recommended so that way you don't have to rebuild the waterfall from scratch. With A/B testing, you really only want to be testing one variable so you can actually see the impact of that change. If you're doing multiple variables, then it will be hard to know like what change actually drove that revenue. So definitely recommend to stay at 50% allocation and copy over your existing waterfall. And so you hit create A/B test, and now your test is created, or your test waterfall is created. So you can see here goes the test waterfall, and here goes your control waterfall. So the control will leave alone. This is your standard waterfall, but the test waterfall is where we'll make changes. So first you're gonna wanna name it. So here we'll say maybe we are changing the, what are we in, an interstitial? We'll say that we're gonna test the frequency cap changes. So we'll say frequency cap, or whatever you want to name it. And then here, if you were testing a new network, here is where you would like enable a network. So if you're testing in Mobi, you would make that change. If you're testing a new mediated network or testing a new price floors within the mediated network, you make those changes here. In this case, we said we're going to test the frequency cap. So we'll hit on, and then we'll select our capping method. We'll say we want to try a new session-based frequency cap. So we'll say 2 ads per session in all countries, but you can change the country if you want. And so from that point, you hit save. And now your, we'll hop back in just so we can see it. Now you can see we have our control group and our test group. So once you've set up your A/B test, it usually takes anywhere from 3 to 5 days for the test to fully mature, and you can get the results to see if there was any meaningful impact. So to analyze the results of the A/B test, you'll come here to the left nav, hit max, and then we will select A/B test under analyze. And then we can see all the A/B tests that we've ran in our app. You can see here that if a test isn't fully mature, meaning we didn't get enough data for it to get the results, then it will let you know that. But if it is ready, then you know the results will become available. So the test I just ran needs time to cook. So we'll just look at another test so you can just get an idea of what the results look like. So the best way to measure performance is to look for ARPDAU increases, like we were saying before. And an ARPDAU increase is just increases in the average revenue per daily active user. A best practice is to look at for at least a 3% increase in ARPDAU as the green light to roll out the changes. And we call this promoting the test. And I will show you how to do that shortly. Anything under 3% should not be promoted, and you can deprecate the test, meaning end the test and not roll it out to your users. So looking at this particular A/B test, we can see that it ran in this app. This was the name of the test. So they were testing a 10-second refresh rate for a banner. And we can see that the ARPDAU increase was nearly 85%, which is very, very good. So this test should definitely be rolled out from 50% of their audience to all of the audience for this particular app and ad unit. We also give you some quick stats to compare. So requests for daily active users, like how many requests increased with this test, how many impressions, how the impressions increased. So we see there was like nearly over a double increase in impressions just from this refresh rate test. The ARPDAU we can see was really successful at 85%, but the eCPM dropped a little bit, which is, fine. We're looking at ARPDAU because this is the most granular way to look at revenue and what's the most influential metric to that would affect your overall revenue. As impressions increase, eCPM is expected to decrease as you serve more impressions. But as long as that ARPDAU is stable or growing, then you're good. So this chart is just expressed in actual numbers here below. So we can see with the 50% allocation, we can see the actual like number values from these charts above. And we can also see the network share of voice and how it changed with the test. So we have the control group in the test. Right here at the top, we have Mentrical at 30%. With the test group, Mentrical's share of voice, revenue share of voice, how much revenue did they make above your pie for this ad unit? Decrease slightly. So this is another good indicator to just see how networks are impacted when you run these A/B tests. So all in all, pretty successful test. So we're going to hop back into our ad unit by going to the left nav, ad units, and we end up on this page, and I will show you how to deprecate or promote a test. So you go back into your ad unit, you toggle to the test waterfall. And once your test is matured and you're ready to either roll it out or end it, you can hit test, the three little dots, and you can say end A/B test. So what this will do is give you the option to deprecate the test. Let's say the test was not successful, you did not see any ARPDAU increases, in which case you want to end the test and revert back to your original waterfall, nothing rolled out to your entire audience. If the test was successful, meaning you saw a positive impact to ARPDAU, then you want to promote the test, meaning the way the test waterfall is set up is now going to be rolled out to all of your users. And through that testing, you should feel pretty confident that the increases you saw within the test group will, you'll see those same increases across your entire audience.